Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone. You are all welcome to lecture number 372. And in the series of lectures on spectroscopic technique, after the completion of IR spectroscopy, NMR spectroscopy, ultraviolet spectroscopy, today I am going to discuss about very interesting spectroscopy that is known as Raman spectroscopy. And Raman spectroscopy actually was discovered by one fine Indian scientist named C.V. Raman. And this spectroscopy is given by his name, that is known as Raman spectroscopy. And he was given Nobel Prize for this work in the year 1930. And in 1954, even he was awarded the highest honor award in India, that is known as Bharat Ratan, for his this new discovery. Here, before going to the Raman spectroscopy, we should know about the phenomenon of light and its interaction with different type of molecules. So when I say light, means it is wavelength. Light means it is electromagnetic radiation. Light means wave and photon. So all together is interlinked. And here, when we are discussing the nature of molecule, ion, compound, atom, in relation to frequency and what changes are going on in vibrational energy or in rotational energy or in electronic energy, then the physics and chemistry, they marry together. There is no difference in physics and chemistry when we are dealing with spectroscopy along with molecular structure. And this gentleman, C.V. Raman, he was awarded the Nobel Prize, that was in physics. So actually he was physicist, but his spectroscopy is widely used in structure determination, even in chemistry also, Raman effect. So before going to that spectroscopy, we should know about the light and its interaction. So first thing is that there are three terms used for light. Those who are having physics background, of course, they will understand. But I am here targeting for those students or the people who are not having the physics background, so at least they should know. Three phenomena is there. First is known as, that is called reflection of light. Second is called a refraction of light. And third one is called scattering of light. So the reflection of light means, when I am saying reflection means, once there is a mirror shining surface, on that shining surface, if light is falling here, and then it will be totally bounced back. It will be bounced back. So bouncing back of the light from the shining surface is known as reflection. And you might have noticed this thing in your glass mirror. Shining mirror, once you see your face, the light will come, it will be reflected. The second one, reflection of light. The second one is refraction. Refraction of light. Reflection of light means, I'm not going in detail because I'm not teaching physics here. But these concepts are very important for Raman spectroscopy. That's why I'm So once light is, here it is for example dense medium water, and it is coming from lighter medium here, and it is water. So once light will enter from air, from air to water, so it will not go straight, it will bend. So the bending of light when it is passing through dense or lighter medium, that is called a reflection. And the third one is that is scattering. Scattering of light means this phenomenon when light is falling or is colliding. The collision of light is taking place with two type of substances. One is elastic and other one is non-elastic. So two conditions are there for scattering. Once the light is striking, hitting the one, I mean two conditions are there. One is elastic and second one is inelastic. So elastic or inelastic means here, if suppose one elastic ball is there and the electromagnetic radiation or light is colliding, the collision is taking place between this elastic particle here, okay, and then this light is scattered with the same frequency from here. There is no transfer of energy. And so here, once the collision is taking place of this electromagnetic radiation or light, once I say electromagnetic radiation means it is wave number, it is frequency, it is photon. It's having same meaning, means it contains energy. And so once this light is, the collision is taking place between this elastic molecule. So elastic molecule means where it will strike, the collision will take place and the light will be scattered with the same frequency, with the same wavelength. There is no loss or gain of any energy. Whatever energy it was having, it has passed through the same energy. That is known as relay scattering. The second condition is sometimes when the light is falling, is collision is taking place, one condition that is elastic and otherwise is inelastic, and where it may be a charged ball, and charged ball may be electron, negative charge or positive charge. So let us take the one which is not elastic is electron and this is charged ball. So once the electromagnetic radiation is the collision, that is elastic collision, here it is, and this is inelastic collision. So the collision of electromagnetic radiation in two conditions, I am talking of scattering of light, from where the Raman spectra starts. So the first condition where the electromagnetic radiation or light is striking or colliding with elastic molecule and passing away, going through it, and there is no loss or gain of energy in that collision, and that is known as relay collision. The second condition is the collision of electromagnetic radiation with charged particle, maybe electron, negatively charged particle. So with that charged particle, if it is hitting, I mean collision is taking place, so there are two possibilities when light is scattered. One possibility is that it may lose the energy, loss of energy. The second is gain of energy. So this is the very interesting detail here, that when the collision of light, radio electromagnetic radiation is taking place with charged particle, and where there is sometimes chance is there that this electron may gain energy, it may receive the energy from this electromagnetic radiation, and after receiving the energy, once it is this particle is coming back here, the photon, it will be having, it has lost the energy, so it will be having longer wavelength. Longer wavelength means, always you know that shorter wavelength contains high amount of energy, Once it has gone to longer wavelength, means energy is less. That's why, let me tell you, scattering very best example. Have you seen the sun? When there is sunset, about to sunset, the whole sky you might have noticed what? Orange color or yellow color or slightly reddish color. Why it is not blue color? Why it is not green color? The reason is that it is the scattering of light when the sun setting is taking place. It has gone towards longer wavelength and that is known as red shift. So two shifting is there of wavelength. One is called red shift. Red shift means where the wavelength is emitted of longer size. And that's why all the sky will notice the orange light red color because of longer wavelength. And why blue is not coming? Because blue is color belongs to shortest wavelength, shorter wavelength like maybe gamma range, X-rays, all those things. So that is blue. This is the best scattering of the light in space. And there are ionosphere, lot of ions, molecules, positive, negative ions. There are responsible and the light is colliding with those and is scattering in the space. So that is the scattering. And here, first condition here, this elastic collision means this molecule is not a charged particle. It is not charged particle, it is a molecule. So this molecule is not having any charge. And here, once it is collision is there, there is no loss or gain of energy. But in the case of charged particle, once collision is taking place with light or electromagnetic radiation, then there will be loss or gain of energy. So with this, I will stop here, and in next lecture, I am going to again explain about this elastic and inelastic nature of collision of light. Thank you very much for watching.